हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल दैट इज़ साइंस अनलॉक्ड। एंड हियर वी आर विद द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर दैट इज़ फिजिकल एंड केमिकल चेंजेस, वेयर वी आर एक्चुअली गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द डिफरेंट सेट ऑफ चेंजेस व्हिच वी कैन लाइक स्पेसिफाई विद रेफरेंस टू अ केमिकल चेंज। सो वन सच चेंज इज द चेंज इन कलर, वेयर वी सी दैट वंस द रिएक्शन हैज़ टेकन प्लेस इट विल गोइंग टू अल्टीमेटली turn itself into a different color which will going to be irreversible. So what we will going to observe here is that these changes are something which may give you the resemblance that as if it is a physical change, but one thing which will going to determine them or differentiate them from the physical changes is that in case of chemical changes, new product is formed and the process is irreversible. So the change that has taken place in the reaction or during the change, that will going to be a permanent change and it cannot be reversed back altogether. So one such example is the tarnishing process, that once that tarnished silver is actually created on the top of the silver, that blackish material is converted, so where the silver loses its shine and turns itself into black color. So that is the scenario where we talk about the change in color, and if you want to remove that, you need to simply remove the tarnished silver from there. One such change is the change in state, where the things can simply convert themselves from solid to liquid or gas and in any other format that you can think about over here. So that will going to be considered as the change which reference to the chemical changes. Now the third category or the third change which will going to determine or which will be able to identify the change is with reference to change in odor. So that is the smell. So what happens is that every time if there will be any kind of change, especially with reference to food articles, we will going to find out that its smell will going to change. So that is what is called as the change in odor. Next we have is the change in temperature. It happens many a times that when a reaction takes place, a chemical change takes place, then in that case there will be a lot and lot of heat released from the setup which we are discussing about or which we are observing altogether. So such kind of reaction or such kind of change is called as the exothermic reaction, because the heat is coming out of the system. It is created inside the system and it is moving out of the system. Now over here I do not mean that the heat is something which can be created altogether. It is the reaction between the molecules of the combining material, that means the reactants altogether or the raw material, because of which ultimately the heat is released. I do not mean that energy can be created over here, because that is the very basic law of energy and universe, that energy can neither be created nor be destroyed and it can only be converted from one form to the other form. So that we have to keep in mind, that this temperature or this heat is nothing but that whole process of conversion of energy only. Last but not the least is the fifth category or fifth change with which we will be able to identify a chemical change, which talks about release of gases. So if in any of the reaction or any of the change that you are observing, if you are seeing this thing that the gases are being released, that can be simply considered as a chemical change. And one such example is the process of the oxidation of food, digestion of food, that is all related with the inhalation of oxygen gas and removal of carbon dioxide gas, because during the cellular respiration the energy is produced from the food and the exchange of gases is done, where intake and outward movement of gases takes place. Now the examples where we can quote almost all these changes is corrosion. Now corrosion is basically the process where we will going to see that a metallic material will going to get converted into a more stable oxide format or the hydroxide and sulfide form of their metal. But this particular process over here, we will going to find out that it is the more stable state of the specific metal which we are referring to. But this particular process is not actually the preferable process, or you can say the appreciated process in nature. Reason being, this kind of process actually helps the metal with reference to its stability in the nature, but it actually causes damage to the natural environment in terms of that we need more and more resources. We need to replace the things which are made up of that particular metal. For example, the bridges that we are making with iron and steel, the ships that we are making all together with iron and steel. So all these things, ones will going to get corroded or simply get oxidized in the nature, will going to lead to the problem where we need to replace all such things. So this is the concept of corrosion, where we talk about the damaging of the different set of metals. Now sometimes this damaging process can actually be useful, that we will be taking up in the coming section of the session, and sometimes it is not preferred. Most of the times it is not preferred, but sometimes it is does. So the first thing that we are looking into is the rusting process, rusting of iron, where the metal iron will going to get rusted out, will going to get oxidized, will lose its shine, will become dull as per the time passes. And because of the process of oxidation, what will going to happen is that the layer of rust will going to be generated onto the metal, which will going to ultimately make it deteriorated and will going to make it useless. So we need to replace the material or replace the iron in the material that we will be using. So that is how this process is not preferred. This is the disadvantage of corrosion process. But a similar kind of process can be acted as a preventive measure, where we talk about the process of galvanization, where what we are doing is we are simply coating the iron articles with zinc layer. Now over here, what we will going to find out, that whichever process we are using to make it galvanized, this is the process that we will be using for the process of galvanization. But over here we will going to find out that this particular add-on layer of zinc will going to act as a protective layer, because once this zinc layer will going to get oxidized, it will prevent the further rusting process or further oxidation process of the article and keep it on the superficial level only. So that is how the same process we are using as a backup or as a preventive measure. Now an alternative to this is the process of alloying, where we will going to simply mix two or more metals in a fixed proportion so that their overall property changes, and that can be used altogether to make something which will not going to show the property of rusting. And one such some sort of different examples that we can quote over here is the brass, which is an alloy of copper and zinc, then bronze, which is made up of copper and tin, and one such example is solder, which is made up of lead and tin. So altogether these things are simply getting mixed up altogether. And like for instance, we have the steel as well, which will going to ultimately make the usage of iron better. On the other hand, if we talk about the impurities which are added to iron, which stops or delays the process of rusting, that is also one such way out where we will be using this particular phenomena of rusting or maybe alloying, which will going to ultimately help in the process of prevention of rusting. Now, one such example that we have in terms of metals oxidation or corrosion processes, rusting of copper. Now, this is something where we will going to find out that when the rust, this copper or the metallic copper will going to react with oxygen and carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, it will going to develop into a green colored coating of copper hydroxide and copper sulfate. Now over here we are simply using the process, because once it is rusted, it will not going to penetrate deeper into the metal, means it will going to prevent the further damage of metal altogether. So wherever we want the metal to be exposed properly, there it is a problem. But a situation like this, that is the Statue of Liberty, this was something where we have not worked on the problem of rusting in case of copper. Reason being, over here it not only prevents the particular statue but also helping in making it more and more beautiful and attractive. So that is something where we are using the rusting process in our favor. Now, one such example is tarnishing of silver, where the silver turns from the shiny surfaces to turn into black or dull surface where it loses its shine because of the reaction with hydrogen sulfide and sulfur present in the air. Now, these are all different set of chemical changes that we have actually learned altogether, and here we need to work and understand these processes so that we can make best use out of it. So which makes it important for us to understand that how exactly we will be able to identify the physical and chemical changes and how we can use them for ourselves altogether. So that is it for today's session, and with this we are done with our chapter as well. So in the next session we will going to take up some new chapter. Till then, take care and keep learning.